Mic3 Wave FM allows you to model a large range of challenging wave problems in a fast and convenient workflow. This tutorial will show you just how fast it can be done. First, start by opening the Mic3 Wave FM application. Then, load your flexible mesh from the Mic Mesh Generator. This example features a small but deep harbour which is exposed to overtopping and wave disturbance in storm situations. It is partly protected by a piece of land to the west and a porous breakwater to the north. You can now set the simulation length and various model parameters, including tuning parameters for the turbulence module. This time we will use default parameters except for the bed resistance. Notice there is no section with wave breaking tuning parameters, since wave breaking is an integral part of the numerical solution. This setup includes a porous breakwater at boundary 3. It is easy to add the porosity zone here just by referring to the relevant boundary code, setting the width, and add a value for the porosity. You will need to define a sponge layer in the southern part of the domain to dampen the waves leaving the model. Again, we simply refer to the boundary code and define a width. Waves are generated in a relaxation zone, which we create by setting a width of the zone and then simply clicking on the map to define the wave generation line. Then click Edit and go to Wave Data. You have many possibilities when specifying the waves. This time we will read a directional spectrum from a spectral wave model representing a severe storm coming from the northwest, stored in a DFS2 file. Choose a directional sector and select the number of wave components to be generated. You can define a number of different outputs. Here we will define 5. First, an area output with 2D data, like surface elevation. Then, a volume output with wave kinematics and other 3D quantities. Next, we define a wave statistics output with significant wave height, maximum surface elevation, skewness, and so on. Also, we add an output with overtopping, with the amount of water crossing this red line. And finally, a gridded area output with interpolated values that may be used with Mic21 mooring analysis and other tools. After defining these outputs, we are ready to start the computation. Let us see the 5 outputs we have defined. This is the area output showing the surface elevation and depth averaged velocities. In the volume file, you can see the wave kinematics. From this, we can make a transect to see the waves propagating over the bar and into the harbour. The statistical output shows the different wave statistics that we selected earlier. The overtopping time series tells you how much water passes the red line we previously defined. The gridded output contains the total water depth and the wave fluxes. As a final thing, see here how the results can be animated using Mic Animator Plus. We hope you've enjoyed the tour. Please contact us for more information.